The Bodo people of Assam are demanding a separate Bodo land because they think living with tribes of Indian ethnicity is leading to the Sanskritization of their culture. Insurgency groups in Nagaland are demanding a sovereign state of Greater Nagalim to unite scattered Naga tribes. And that's just the big two. Over 25 other demands for statehood and independence are littered across the Seven Sisters. And at the root of this agitation is the fact that the borders of our northeastern states don't seem to match the identities of the people that inhabit them. Until 1926, Tibetan and Burmese monarchs ruled what is today's northeast India. Worried that these kingdoms may expand westward, the British annexed this territory before anyone else got the chance. When the independence movement gathered steam, ethnic differences were put aside to overthrow the common enemy, and after 1947, these states became a de facto part of India. India had absorbed this region into its national territory without completely understanding it, and this would prove to be a massive problem when it became time to draw India's state lines. While the rest of the country was divided on a linguistic, cultural, and historical basis, drawing state lines in the northeast was an administrative nightmare. With around 200 tribes, 145 communities, and 220 languages, it would mean creating hundreds of states in only 8% of India's total area. Obviously, similar groups would have to be bundled together. Since these groups were completely distinct from central India, ethnically, politically, historically, and linguistically, this bundling was grossly inaccurate. Soon after these lines were drawn, the conflicts began, amongst themselves and against the center. Which brings us to the situation today. A Nepali-speaking population desperately wants independence from a state that is forcing them to learn and speak Bengal. The Angami people want to erase the state line that divides them, and fed up of sharing their land with rival tribals, Kuki guerrilla groups have been raising hell in Manipur. And the Bodo and Naga movements have led to thousands of lost lives. Things are so bad that there is constant army presence in four of the states, which has made locals even angrier. It's not just the internal lines that are problematic. 99% of the northeast border is an international one. Groups along the Arunachal Pradesh-China border but feel a greater ethnic affinity to China have escalated this internal conflict into an international one, giving passage to Chinese militants into India. In 1971, the influx of Bangladeshi immigrants during the Indo-Pak War further diluted the Northeast identity. Bengali-speaking Muslim refugees did not easily assimilate with the local Tibetan-Burmese tribes, creating more discontent amongst the people who already believed that their culture was being diluted. With so much political instability, this part of India has been long neglected in terms of development and social welfare. Redrawing state lines here would be as much of a nightmare today as it was in 1947. But is there any other way to reimagine India's northeast? Tell us in the comments below.